you're on the road, must have a code that you can live by. And so become yourself, because the past is just a goodbye. Teach your children well.
We have the opportunity to send President Obama back to Chicago. Or Kenya.
Cause the father's hell did slowly go by, and feed them on your dreams. The one they fix, the one you know by. Don't you ever ask them why. If they told you, you would cry. So just look at them and sigh, and know they love you.
That your elders grew by, and so please help them with your youth.
You
they seek the truth before they can die.
Teach your parents well, cause their children's hell will slowly go by. On your dreams, the one they fix, the one you know by. Don't you ever ask them why. If they told you, you would cry. So just look at them and sigh, and know they love you.
Hi, everybody. 4 years after the worst economic crisis of our lifetimes, we're seeing signs that, as a nation, we're moving forward again. After losing about 800,000 jobs a month when I took office, our businesses have now added 5.2 million new jobs over the past 2.5 years. And on Friday, we learned that the unemployment rate is now at its lowest level since I took office. More Americans are entering the workforce. More Americans are getting jobs. But too many of our friends and neighbors are still looking for work or struggling to pay the bills, many of them since long before this crisis hit. We owe it to them to keep moving forward. We've come too far to turn back now. We've made too much progress to return to the policies that got us into this mess in the first place. For example, 2 years ago, we put in place tougher, common sense rules of the road for Wall Street to make sure that the kind of crisis we've been fighting back from never happens again. These rules mean that big banks are no longer going to be able to make risky bets with your deposits. And if a big bank does make a bad decision, they pay for it, not taxpayers. And we also put in place the strongest consumer protections in our history to crack down on the worst practices of credit card companies and mortgage lenders. But for some reason, some Republicans in Congress are still waging an all-out battle to delay, defund, and dismantle these common sense new rules. Why? Do they think that undoing the rules that protect families from the worst practices of credit card companies and mortgage lenders will make the middle class stronger? Do they think getting rid of the rules to prevent another crisis on Wall Street will make Main Street any safer? Republicans in Congress need to stop trying to refight the battles of the past few years and finally start doing something to actually help the middle class get ahead. And here, there are three things they can do right now. First, Congress needs to step up and guarantee that 98% of Americans and 97% of small business owners won't see their taxes go up next year. This is something that everyone says they agree on. It should have gotten done months ago, but Republicans in Congress are standing in the way. They're holding tax cuts for 98% of Americans hostage until we pass tax cuts for the wealthiest 2% of Americans. Ask them how that helps the middle class. Second, Congress needs to step up and provide every responsible homeowner a chance to save about $3,000 a year on their mortgage by refinancing at lower rates. I gave them a plan to do that back in February. It's a plan that has the support of independent, nonpartisan economists and leaders across the housing industry. But Republicans won't even let that plan come to a vote. Ask them how that helps homeowners. Third, Congress needs to step up and pass my plan to create a Veterans Job Corps to help our returning heroes find work as cops, firefighters, and park rangers in communities across the country. A few weeks ago, Republicans in the Senate voted that plan down. Ask them why someone who fights for this country abroad should have to fight for a job when they come home. In other words, ask them to get back to work and get these things done. If we're going to keep this economy moving forward, there's no time for political games, even in a political season. Everyone needs to do their part. If you agree with me, let your representative know where you stand. Tell them that if they want your vote, then they need to stand with you and not in the way of our recovery. Thanks, and have a great weekend.